Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, DwyerVIP.com. Look us up on Roku. We're in the sports section, Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. On iTunes, one word, Dwyer Boxing News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, I've been having an ongoing conversation here online about Gennady Golovkin. As longtime subscribers know, I touted Golovkin when he was on the way up. I made a video a few years ago where I talked about the bright futures of two fighters, Gennady Golovkin and Tyson Fury. Since that video, neither fighter has lost, right? But understand, this is the part of the internet where we point out things like Ali did not go to the body. Vladimir Klitschko today does not go to the body. Joe Lewis has slow foot speed. Floyd Mayweather's legs are not what they once were. Right? Understand here, we'll take the best fighters, elite fighters, and we'll try to dissect them to point out strengths and weaknesses. Right, the goal here is to get an edge on the casino. Right, Sonny Liston, loved him, had a problem cutting off the ring. Couldn't handle a mobile Ali. Right, with that in mind, Gennady Golovkin is now one of the biggest names in boxing. Right, many of you fiercely defend his reputation. The Las Vegas lines, in my opinion, couldn't be more absurd. This fight against Marco Antonio Rubio, a guy who's been in the ring with fighters like Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. Understand, he went the distance with Chavez Jr. Right? Marco Antonio Rubio is a 16-1 underdog. 16-1. The casinos want you to believe that if these guys fought 17 times, that Gennady Golovkin would win 16 of the 17. Right? Well, my point to you is simply this. There's only one way to play this fight. I believe if you're trying to get a leg on the casino, you have to take Marco Antonio Rubio to win the fight, hedged with Golovkin by KO. Understand, this is a WBA-WBC title fight. It's scheduled to go 12 rounds, right? A lot would have to happen for this fight to go 12 rounds, right? If Marco Antonio Rubio pulls the upset, and folks, I'm here to make the argument that he's a live dog, right? Then, of course, for every dollar you bet on him, the casino is going to give you that dollar back and give you 16 additional dollars. Right, I believe that that's the play because I believe this is a competitive fight. Now let's do the homework together. What I want people to do is to look in my favorites on my YouTube channel page. You're going to see three videos. Right? Part one, part two, part three. Of Marco Antonio Rubio's fight against David Lemieux. Now, there was a time where David Lemieux was viewed as the future of boxing. David Lemieux, going into his fight against Marco Antonio Rubio, was 25-0 with 24 knockouts. Lemieux is a hellacious puncher. What I want people to do, and let's turn the tables here, right? YouTube Nation, I'm calling on you. What I want people to do is to tell me as they look at the video, what's the difference between Gennady Golovkin and David Lemieux? Right? Both explosive punchers. Both guys who like to get a lot of torque into their punches. both big time juggernauts early in fights. So I'm serious here. In the comment section to this video, just tell me exactly what Golovkin does that Lemieux doesn't do. Let me tell you what happened in the Marco Antonio Rubio fight. Rubio survives the early rounds. That's the best word that can be used for it. He gets by. Lemieux comes in, tries to empty the gun on him. A lot of the early rounds is just Rubio behind a high guard, blocking punches. Now let me point out, that's exactly what's needed against Gennady Golovkin. Some defense. You can't trade with him. The Marco Antonio Rubio strategy, in my opinion, is the strategy against Gennady Golovkin. You actually see it here in the Lemieux fight. He has a high guard. He weathers the storm. Then he starts throwing a straight jab. Then he starts throwing straight overhand rights. Right now, my point to you is simply this. He ultimately ends up stopping Lemieux. Such a point that Lemieux's corner pulls the plug in the middle rounds. Right now, are you certain that that can't happen to Gennady Golovkin? You saw Daniel Gill have a wide open shot on Golovkin right before he gets decked. Are you certain that as Golovkin comes in throwing heavy punches, that he doesn't leave himself open to straight counters? Are you certain, too, that Golovkin has the stamina where, if a wily veteran like Marco Antonio Rubio is able to, behind a high guard, take the fight into the middle rounds, are you certain that Golovkin is going to have the stamina to actually push the fight into the later rounds? How do you know he's not going to get decked like David Lemieux? Understand, Lemieux, again, 25-0, 24 KOs. Right? Also, aren't you a bit concerned that Rubio is the kind of guy who can go into Canada and knock out David Lemieux and can fight Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. in a fight clouded by a drug testing controversy? Right? It's unclear whether the protocol was followed in testing Chavez Jr. But yet, in that fight, Rubio goes the distance against a guy who's big at middleweight. Right? Understand, Chavez Jr. would gain something like 20 pounds after a weigh-in. Right? What exactly is it that Gennady Golovkin is bringing to the table that middleweight Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., a guy who destroyed Andy Lee, destroyed him, did not bring to the table? Because we know Rubio goes the distance with Chavez Jr. My argument to you is, Rubio has the kind of defense where he can push this to the middle rounds. Right? He has the kind of mental toughness where, against a bigger man coming inside throwing bombs like, you know, Chavez Jr. did, or in a foreign country where Lemieux gets a standing ovation when he enters the ring, Rubio has the kind of mental toughness to actually go the distance against Chavez Jr. and KO David Lemieux, right? Have Lemieux's corner retire him in a fight where Rubio's really dominated the first two rounds of that fight, right? And so, to YouTube Nation, tell me what makes Golovkin more special than David Lemieux. right? Is it Marco Antonio Rubio's overhand right hand going to be a problem for Golovkin once he tires? Right? My point to you is, before you fool around with an over-under, you need to take a taste at a 16-1 home run play. Right? The bet I'm recommending here, and understand I'm covered if Golovkin does what he normally does, get KOs. The bet I'm recommending here is Marco Antonio Rubio to win the fight, hedged with Golovkin by KO. Understand the Rubio side of the play, you're getting 16-1 odds. Simply ridiculous. Let me make another point on Rubio. Rubio lost to Kelly Pavlik. Pavlik is exactly the kind of fighter who would give Rubio problems, because understand, Kelly Pavlik was tall, had a long jab, knew how to shoot straight, right? He could throw down on Marco Antonio Rubio. Here, Rubio is practically the same height as Gennady Golovkin. You don't have that length dynamic that you had in the Kelly Pavlik fight. But a word of caution, these guys actually weighed in 30 days before the fight. Golovkin weighed 165. I like that, because I don't like guys gaining too much weight between bouts. Marco Antonio Rubio weighed in the mid-170s. I don't like that, especially for 34-year-old fighters, right? Because he's going to have to drain himself in camp. There's a flip side to it, though. Just understand that Marco Antonio Rubio considers himself to be the bigger man than Gennady Golovkin. He's not going to be blown away by Golovkin's size, right? Understand, he's already gone the distance with Chavez Jr. So let me hear from you. I'm a fan of Gennady Golovkin's, but I want a taste of this 16-1 odds on Marco Antonio Rubio, and I'm going to hedge the play with Golovkin by KO. Let me know how you're playing it. More importantly, tell me the difference between Golovkin and David Lemieux, right? At least concede that Lemieux was viewed as a world beater when he had a KO ratio over 90%, right? When he ran into Marco Antonio Rubio. Also understand, too, that Rubio is training with Robert Garcia. Robert Garcia is an elite trainer who, when he has a guy who knows how to throw a jab, is able to have that guy use length in the ring. Isn't the length and straight punches going to be a problem for Golovkin? What happens if Golovkin comes up on Rubio and Rubio just turtles? Right? Doesn't exchange like Daniel Gill, but actually just has a guard up with the mindset of having Golovkin punch himself out. Is there a possibility of a rumble in the jungle type of scenario here? Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Thanks for stopping by.